This lesson covers the process how to create the orthographic drawings in OpenPlant Modeler. Launch OpenPlant Modeler and create a new file called Snapshot or follow the project or company naming standard. This file will contain all of the references of the various disciplines that the orthographic drawings should be based on. Once OpenPlant Modeler opens, go to the References tool and attach the training session file, which has all the references attached to it. Then, arrange views to show four of them at the same time. The two commands that will be used are located under the Annotate ribbon menu, and they are called Plan Callout and Section Callout. Use the Plan Callout button first. Then select Plan View File as the drawing seat of this plan drawing. Next, left-click on the first point, which will be the left side of the plan view. The second point will be the right side of the plan view, and the third point will define the depth of the plan. Once the Create Drawing dialog appears, name this view Plan Top 1 and keep switched on options to create a drawing model and a sheet model. In this example, these orthographic drawings will not be created in the model file, but the separate file will be created. With the plus icon, the new file is created to place the Plan Top 1 drawing in. In this case, it will be called Ortho Drawing 01. Then set the annotation scale to full size 1:1. Next, in the Create Sheet Model section, browse to the file the sheet model should be placed in. In this example, it will be the same file as the drawing model, which is the ortho underscore drawing 01. Then set the annotation scale to full size 1:1 and select the detail scale to be placed at 1:100 in this case. At this point, please make sure the Open Model box is toggled on. Then click OK button and the application will now switch over to the orthographic drawing. Once the drawing appears, notice that the used seed file has already got predefined the border and the title block, scale, and other model, file, or workset properties can be automatically synchronized with the title block. This plan view is just a reference file, so it can be easily moved to the proper location. Next, use a section callout tool. So, go to the Annotate Ribbon tab and select the Section Callout button. Choose the drawing seed, section view. Select two points to define the clip line, and then the third point to define how deep into the model clip should go. Now the same Create Drawing Model dialog appears. This time the view will be called Section Side 1. Again, the drawing can be created in the active or separate file. In this example, this is a section that should be placed on this sheet, so the section will be saved directly in this file. Set the annotation scale to full size 1:1. This time change the visible edges to dynamic, which will enable to dynamically see the result of changes made to the clip volume. Set the detail scale. This time the model should not be opened. As the section side 1 view should be placed in the active file in the Plan Top 1 sheet, click OK button to get that section side view inserted on this sheet. Afterwards, move the section view into the correct location. At this point, the clipping plane, marked with the green arrow, can be adjusted. As an example, drag it past the horizontal tank. Notice that the horizontal vessel disappears from the section side view. The clipping plane can be dynamically controlled. Annotations and dimensioning can be placed by using the tools from Annotate Ribbon. In this example, start with simple label placement. Choose the Place Text tool. Once the text editor dialog appears, select the Insert Field button and select the element properties in the field type box, then pick the vessel or other component to annotate. Any property of the element can be placed as annotation. In this example, choose the element description of the vessel. Then click OK button and place the label text in the drawing. To create annotation with the leader line, choose the Place Note tool. Again, in the Text Editor dialog, choose the Insert Field button and then select the Element Properties. Pick a pipeline, this time select the Name property. Start placing the note by picking the leader line location and then the location of the annotation. Now place a couple of dimensions. Use the Dimension Linear tool from the dimensioning group of the Annotate ribbon. Dimension the distance between two pipes by clicking two points on their center lines and locating the dimension line with the dimension text. Similarly, dimension the distance between two pumps.